buckle up, strap in, come along for the ride. Let's have some fun.
Bro, I wish I could see that far. No SPD sleeves. Made it like 3 sets in, take them off. Time to start this series. We're gonna call it applying pressure. Ironically, because I learned how to do foot pressure last night. Foot pressure. Foot pressure, foot pressure, foot pressure. Official introduction, here we go. Name's Emmanuel Harris. I am blank years old at Exceed Performance, best gym in California. Kind of newbie power lifter. Recording so I can document my process and how I get through the days and, you know, everything that involves powerlifting, because I'm trying to be really good at it. I think I have a lot of potential, so I just want to push it. If I told you I never knew what foot pressure was and I've been squatting all this, would you believe me? Pretty wild. Hopefully just post all of my workouts consistently, you're gonna get more of a raw. You know, not really a lot of edits because I'm not good at editing. Last one for the top set, we got 190 for a set of 3. Paused. At 7, okay. That's new. Larson press. Whoa. I've never Larson before, this should be fun. Interesting. I'm not gonna lie, that is the heaviest 375 has ever felt on my back in my life. My lord. All right, 190, AKA 418 for pauses. First, actually, bathroom break. Yeah, this ain't gonna make it. It did not feel like I thought it was going to. Still a 6, but my lat on my left side is always terrible on Mondays. I don't know why. So more mobility stuff. So what I'm doing now, I've been catching these cramps in my feet. Well, it's really just my right one, strange. But I think it's because my sodium levels are super low. I don't eat a lot of salt. So I just mixed tri-oil with Gatorade. Today marks the day I start my dieting bad cooking. After my competition last month, I have been eating any and everything I can get my hands on. Not anymore. I'm still gonna eat a lot, but I wanna cook. Well, then we're gonna start with 3,000 calories, see how that does. And then we'll go from there. Honestly, this last year, I've been at like 1,800 calories while prepping for competitions. Would not recommend it. Also don't recommend if it's, you know, your first year of powerlifting, just compete at whatever weight you're at. It's not worth it with the cutting, just compete at your natural weight. Go from there. All right, so back downs. I've got 375 for a set of 7. RP 6. I think I lost count. That was either 8 or it was a 7, I don't know. Okay, backing it down. It's like 340, 4 set of 5. So I just made it through my top and my back down. This does not feel great, but we're gonna push through. If you stumbled upon my page, you're in for a treat. You're about to see a mix of a crackhead and just overall happy person in the gym. I'm gonna try my best to limit the editing on this page because I saw, I can't remember what his name is, I'll put it in the description or something, but I saw this guy this weekend. He was just posting his workouts and they were raw, unedited, like, you know, it was just cuts. And he was like talking through his workout and it was really wholesome. And I kind of relate to that because, you know, if you've ever seen me work out when it comes to like me, PRs, anything, I don't really get too hype. I just go, you know. It's like I enjoy just coming to this gym. It's called Exceed Performance, and it's just a good time, you know. My life changed once I got here for the better. So I'm just hoping I can continue to grow and get stronger here. I just want to show the ins and outs of prepping for a powerlifting competition from somebody that's relatively new. I feel like everybody always shows like the super highs. You don't really get a lot of the lows. I had a lot of lows before my last meet, but you know, just the fact that I made it through the prep was good enough for me, and I did pretty well. But now it's time to put on some weight and hopefully get stronger and see how competitive I can actually be, you know? So welcome to the page. Just for reference, I'm probably like 188 right now. 178 about a month ago, about a little bit of a month and a half ago. Not anymore. Big boy season. Big boy season. You know, I'm not making this page to, you know, glorify myself or anything. I'm a normal human being who just loves a workout, bro. That's it. I stay in my lane and work out. I'm also in school. And I'm a professional napper. Professional napper. Excuse my heavy breathing. I'm an asthmatic. Whew. Squats are done. Now, Larson press. I've never done them before, so this is probably gonna be goofy. I am looking to compete in November. This wonderful gym is having another competition. And this time, what I'm not gonna do is set unrealistic expectations. I feel like that's what a lot of us end up doing. We put a lot of pressure on ourselves. But one thing I've lived by, and even with these unrealistic expectations, is just bring your own best, BYOB. Bring your own best. I'm done worrying about like what I weigh. I'm done worrying about who's gonna be at the competition. Do your best. I tell other people never follow it. It's always hard to follow your own advice. So I think with Larson, you set up normal. I'm no expert. You set up normal. Hopefully I don't look too stupid. Man, I'm generous. Yeah. I always put clips on, always. Always. Your boy, clumsy. No, in my luck, the second I don't put my clips on, tink, tink. Poor little tink, tink. I'm gonna go to court. Fuck. Larson press. Okay. So far, so good. Moving on to the accessory section. Got some belt squats, some Bulgarian split squats. Probably do goblet squats because I don't like using the leg press here. Lat pull downs. That's a wrap. Do your accessories. Don't skip accessories. Don't just skip your back downs. It's time to really find your potential, Emmanuel. Stretch more. That's my problem. I don't stretch. I never stretch. I don't have a warm up. So I want to find like a video for each lift. Start doing those warm ups for each lift. Do mobility stuff at night or just when I'm at home. Lay off the weed this week. Get focused again. I just want to be great in my own way. Yeah. Yeah. Bring your own best. And one thing is just like you never want to forget, you know, where you were. Like last year I was 200 pounds on the brink of depression, just working out for fun, not realizing that this was like a passion that was gonna grow. And I got here and it was just like, wow, I'm actually like kind of good at this. And you know, the people I was around really helped me a lot. Changed my perspective on a lot of stuff and just helped me grow into the lifter that I am now. And like last year, I just stopped trying to please everybody, just did what made me happy. And I'm such a good place mentally. I want to keep that going. I want to use that for other people, inspire other people, encourage other people. I love encouraging people. You can do it. If I can, you can. My uncle told me he squatted 605 back in the day. Of course, there's no footage. So I'm hoping, you know, no, I know I'm going to do it. I want to do 275 kilos. That's exactly 606. Beat him by 1 pound. Workout done. Welcome to the journey. I'm not trying to be like your favorite lifter. I'm not trying to be the strongest lifter. I just want to put out good vibes. That's it. So hopefully you stick around.